All right, so thank you everybody for joining in today. Today it's almost the ninth session, I believe, ninth or the tenth session, but we still have a few more topics to be covered for this Sunday batch, right? And I've just spoken about the stuff which we have covered last time, a sort of a recap for the email marketing. I hope I don't need to take all the slides one after another. I've shared across the URL which you can refer for all the recordings. So Shadab, this is also for you as well. I'm sharing across the URL where you can get some of the recordings, not all of the recordings, some of the recordings of the sessions which we are having. Plus, along with that, most of the presentations which I'm sharing across, which I use for overall course, you can go ahead and create an account, sign up on Digital Marketing Pathshala website, and check for all the details, all the lessons right up here. So this particular page, which I have opened, shared with you just now, does have all the lessons which we are going to cover. I'll keep adding more lessons to it, guys, to this particular thing. But you can always refer to these lessons, which I'm going to take in the sessions today, and also so forth and so on. All right. So today we're going to start with YouTube marketing. I hope everybody knows that YouTube is the second highest usable search engine after Google. YouTube is also, you know, owned by Google. Earlier it was a separate entity altogether, but Google went ahead and purchased YouTube. I think it was 3 years or 4 years back somewhere where it was being done. Hi Guru Prasad, welcome to the session. So what exactly we as a business owner, let's say if we are working for a client or we are working for ourselves, what all things should we consider for promoting stuff on YouTube? Having presence on YouTube is something which you can't, forget, because that's one of the major platforms which should be used for promotion on the internet world. There are certain things which you should take care in mind while promoting your brand on the YouTube. First of all, definitely is to sign up on YouTube. You can do that across with the help of a Gmail account. And then after that, what sort of videos, what sort of stuff you should share across, where I will talk about the content which one should share across on YouTube in the most effective fashion. And what these videos which you're going to have, what these should be all about. All right. So all right, so you already know my background, right? And why video? So this particular slide talks about the agenda. My background, I hope most of you already know about my background. You are connected with me on WhatsApp or whichever way, or the emails and all. So my even LinkedIn profile is right there with me, right there with each one of you. You are connected with me on LinkedIn as well. In case not, you can feel free to connect with me. Why video? We have already answered that. Videos is the next in thing, guys, when it comes to overall, just a sec. So video is the next thing when it comes to, you know, the content part. After the text content, it's only the video part which is being consumed the most. Rather, in upcoming years, the video part, the video content is going to be consumed the most as compared to the text part. And how do we use video as a marketing platform? We'll talk about that and what you can do in order to get started with it, and some of the helpful links I'm going to talk about. All right. All right. So why video? We have already, so it's the second largest search engine. That's why we are looking at that. And YouTube has changed the way, you know, we discover information online. I hope most of you would have really started using, internet in a different fashion over the period of time. Videos are being used much more by online shoppers these days. This has been seen as compared to reading blogs, reading news, or reading anything in a written format. If I have to buy something today, then probably I would go ahead and type in to gather, you know, I type in my keywords in a YouTube channel as compared to a Google channel, because many people want to see an imagery stuff in motion. That's why YouTube has really changed the way, you know, the search engines are being used and internet is being used across. When I talk about the size of YouTube, guys, it's there are plenty of billions of videos which are being uploaded every single second. Every single second, hundreds of videos are being uploaded, and the reach is tremendous in terms of, if I just talk about target audience within the age group of 18 to 34, they are the ones who are using videos the most. And it has, it keeps processing more than 3 billion searches a month. So these are certain stats, guys, which I'm sharing across with you. So just good to know information. I'll come on to the practical stuff, which will specifically talk about what sort of content, what sort of stuff we should have over the YouTube channel. All right. So why people have been using videos, there are certain stats which says that 96% people find that videos are helpful for online purchasing decisions. If I have to buy a particular product today, let's say if I have to buy a car or a mobile phone or a laptop, and I have to make a decision, people generally go and try and find out stuff over the videos. 96% people find videos to be much more helpful. And 71% people said, again, these are certain stats, guys. 71% people said that watching video increase the trust in the brand. Because of this, if you can just understand that because of videos, the trust has increased. That's why it makes a lot of sense to, go ahead and invest into the video content. If I own a particular brand which is into, let's say, the automobile, and I create videos for it, people would go and, would come across and check my channel and see those videos, and the overall benefit would actually come out of that. I hope everybody would agree to that. Can you share anybody? I mean, it's a question to each and everybody. What? Give me any instant where you have used a video to do any research and it has sort of proved to be handy for you. Wherever you have made a decision in terms of buying something, many times, says Lena. All right. Yes. So definitely, video plays a very big role in terms of encouraging, enticing the end customer in terms of giving value, in terms of changing their buying decision. And I generally do that whenever I have to buy something. I go for the product description or something. So Tina says we have, I mean, using for setting up Outlook, email, or Mac. Absolutely. So whenever you have technical problem also, you want to find something with related to technology, we use that. Guru Prasad says to replace RAM, I have to go through the video on YouTube. Absolutely makes sense. And Nitin says I've done in downloading contents in schools. Absolutely. So definitely, in somewhere or the other, YouTube, the overall consumption of YouTube content has a YouTube or videos content rather, videos content have increased, and YouTube is the major player when it comes down to the video stuff. That's why this is something which is not to be ignored by a digital marketer, right? 73% people say that they make a purchase after viewing the video, right? So, okay. I have Animesh saying I'm not getting your voice. So Animesh, if you can just log out and log in again. All right. So 73 people say that just they make a purchase after viewing the video. Viewing the video have turned so many turned the overall buying decision of so many people. So why not? Why not we do it for our clients, or why not we do it for ourselves? That's the next thing, guys. Okay, so how to use YouTube as a marketing platform? Whatever I'm going to tell you today or in the next session, maybe it's not going to be much technical, guys. The way we have done Google AdWords, or the way we have done, what do you say, search engine optimization, the on page, the off page, and all that stuff, they were something which had a technical element to it. When I say technical, I mean something which involved a lot of a practical practice to be done, so that to get them understand. But with this one, it's not going to be a lot of problem. These are pretty easy to digest and easy to understand things, guys. All right. So how do we use YouTube as a marketing platform? Easy stuff, like I was telling you. There are so I've represented certain tech content ideas which you can use for producing videos for your particular channels. You can create channels within YouTube profiles. Get these channels created with the help of certain themes being created. You can have a channel one where you can have video unboxing. Now, just to give you an example, what video unboxing would mean, let's say I have a particular product which is iPhone 6. All right. Now, iPhone 6, I go ahead and I'm selling this across. I take that product, open it, show it across to everyone, and record that video. Has anybody of you seen a product unboxing kind of a video, mobile unboxing? Right. Just give me a moment. Right, so a phone, Arena, I'll just give you an example. So if I type in, let's say, iPhone 6 unbox. You would see plenty of videos which are being shared by so many people where you can get to see people are unboxing their stuff. Right, so you can see these unboxing videos and a huge number of hits are being
Hey guys,
over
Mike
here.
here, the Detroit Borg, and I'm pretty excited to bring you the new.
This is one of the example, guys. This is the one of the example of a YouTube video which is being created. So these are certain text, certain contents which one can create. Either it's these are comparison videos or unboxing videos also. I have seen so many people creating videos, whether it's a comparison of whatever sort of a product. So I hope everybody has seen such kind of videos. If not, I would recommend you to just have a look at some of the examples of these videos. Type in content like whatever product you want to type in, let's say Wi-Fi router unboxing or whatever, you would get a lot of information. Even if I have to type, I have to get information about certain. So can you tell unboxing? I missed that part. Okay, unboxing website videos are like these ones, where you can see plenty of people, going ahead and recording. Overall, recording the stuff, recording the overall process of unboxing a particular product. So this particular video, which I have shared, Lena, earlier on, this video talks about how a iPhone 6, if it's been bought, how can you open, configure it, and then use it. And these are also used for comparisons, also as well. You can see with this particular video, it says iPhone 6 versus iPhone 6 Plus. So what I'm trying to tell you that you as digital marketers will never ever create these videos, but you are being used as idea generators in whichever organization you will go. You will be asked on what sort of strategy should be used for promotion of the brand on the YouTube channel. You probably might end up joining a particular organization. Let's say if you are with any organization and you're helping them with digital marketing or marketing, whatever. The idea has to come from your end. You have to tell them that they are missing out presence on the YouTube channel, which is very much needed. And if they have to create a presence, then what sort of content should they create? If you give them an idea, the idea in terms of the content which needs to be there, you can let them know that yes, you should go ahead and create video unboxing kind of videos, right? If this particular product, if the product has something to do with unboxing. If it's not, then you can't do. Let's say if it's an automobile product, a sort of a test drive kind of a thing can also be checked that. So let's say. So there are plenty of people who have typed in Ford EcoSport review, something of that sort. These kind of videos, or for automobile, you can see Renault Duster versus Ford EcoSport. People are typing in such kind of video. Words and there are certain
Hard
videos.
strength steel.
There are certain videos which are present like this. Right. So that's one of the example, guys. And these are majorly being sp mostly sponsored by these automobile players only. You cannot go ahead and create these since you don't have the knowledge of film production. You really need to have knowledge about that. you as digital marketers who can only just give examples or just give ideas on what should be done, right? The other are the how-tos and how-to-dos tutorials. So when we talk about how-to-do tutorials, probably things like recipe videos, all right? I hope most of you would have seen something like that. I'm just giving you an example. So how to hack Wi-Fi password. This is one of the thing which people are talking about. So how to cook chicken biryani. This is something, you know, people create certain videos and embed their brand within that. That's the idea behind YouTube. So what I'm doing, I'm just giving you an example of what sort of content should be there. Unboxing videos, product comparisons, how-to videos. These might sound very easy stuff for you guys, but when it comes down to, you know, overall, when it comes down to overall giving ideas or creation, then you really miss out on certain stuff. The reason behind me showcasing all that is to give you an example of the content which one should have as part of their YouTube channels. So Guru Prasad says, I made video on how to stuff I have shared earlier. Absolutely. So in the last session, Guru Prasad had shared a video on how can you download videos from YouTube. So these kind of videos absolutely makes a lot of sense. So video unboxing, how to tutorials, and then you have product comparisons. I've already shared with you a product comparison video like of that of iPhone 6 versus iPhone 6 Plus, or you have that Ford EcoSport versus the Renault Duster, or even if you type comparison, okay, so you can see a lot of comparison between Honda City and Verna. These are certain videos which you can get, right? So automobile section, then you have comparison between, I mean, you can take any of those, let's say. So there's MacBook Pro and MacBook Air. So why my MacBook Air or Retina MacBook Pro 13? So these are certain comparison videos, guys. Right. So how-to videos, product comparisons, unboxing. You can always get to see even there are various brands which are using these tactics in the shoes category also. So I can type in, let's say, unboxing Nike Air Max 2015, let's say. So even the shoes box, you know, brands are using that. The apparel brands are using all these things. This is getting way too popular in India as well. Otherwise, in the Western countries, these product comparison videos are like the most, I would say, major decision makers. People make a lot of decision when they have used these, they have, you know, consumed this kind of content with the help of these videos. So you as digital marketers should focus always on getting such kind of websites being, sorry, videos being created across. For whatever brands you are working, you can give them an example. I am sharing certain links, guys. You can go ahead and check them out. So, you know, this is a particular video where an individual who is trying to open up a particular Nike Air shoe box, he is giving information. So this, you would see, this is not being done by Nike at all. This is not being sponsored. But somewhere or the other, this particular person who has even shared 1527 videos, 1500 videos, he would have got money somewhere or the other from Nike. So Santosh says, is it legal to compare our company product with other company? Absolutely. So if you are not doing from the company's point of view, what these organizations are doing, they are providing money to all these influencers. When I say influencers, people who are doing really well on YouTube, who are already giving their opinions about certain products. Let's say I am a tech blogger. Okay, people really follow me and really listen to me a lot. And I share a lot of videos. I share a lot of videos on what is a good mobile phone to buy and which is not a, which is a bad mobile phone or whatever. If people are really following me, following my videos, looking at my videos, let's say I get approached by iPhone and I'm being said that please create a video which is a comparison related video. This all happens behind the scenes. Nobody can get to know whether this particular blogger is being sponsored by someone. They would showcase the comparisons in a very professional fashion that you cannot really judge whether that blogger is being sponsored by some brand or not. They would give a very, very diplomatic answers. They would give facts and figures, but very intelligently, they would focus on the benefits of that product from which they have got the money, whether it's money or any other sort of incentives. Recently, one of my friend actually got this same thing done. They were being asked to blog about Kerala tourism, and people who were doing really well on that, they were being benefited across with free stay, free Kerala trip. There was a blogger being selected from every country, and there were bloggers from 76 countries altogether who went to Kerala. They all were, you know, clicking across pictures and sharing across on blogs. These all were influencers. Intentionally, brands focus on, you know, connecting with these influencers. When I say influencers, these are those people who are being followed a lot on social media profiles. You as digital marketer would always need to, first of all, decide on what sort of content has to be created for brand. Either you do it yourself or you get it done from these influencers. There can be two things. You can create your own channel from your brand ID. So, but you have to be careful in terms of what sort of videos you have to create. You cannot legally do that. Santosh, the question which you asked. In your brand channel, you cannot compare your brand with the others till the time you haven't taken permission from them. But you, if you get it done from your other, you know, as a day-to-day consumer who does that, you hire a day-to-day customer or consumer who compares that product and gets that video up with the comparison, then it's perfectly fine. That's what everybody is doing these days. Right. So these are how-to videos. And then you have videos like product comparison. And then I spoke about even product reviews. People give a lot of reviews about various brands and various products. That what is this product all about? And then there are certain torture testing videos also. Probably you might have seen. I'm not really sure if somebody has seen that, product reviews and torture videos. Let me give you an example. So see, this one was an unboxing and also a review kind of a video. The Nike one, if you can see, this person has unboxed the entire pair of shoes and is also giving across his inputs in terms of how he feels after wearing these. He would be giving all the critics to it. He would be also talking about the great stuff. The camera is focused very much on the product. His voice is getting recorded. He's very much audible and the product is in focus, right? If you check it, all the other videos which this particular guy has created, it would be always... Okay, so a lot of how-to videos he has created. And... Right, and a lot of other unboxing videos also. A lot of products, okay. So, he's a sort of a video blogger. He's a sort of a video blogger who's doing a lot of video blogging to get some money with the help of these videos which he's creating. Some of the torture testing videos I can show you. So this is one of the torture tests I've seen on iPhone where people go ahead and, you know, just do a sort of a hammer burst, you know, blast the hammer on the screen of the iPhone, and then they see what happens to the phone. The idea behind is to actually showcase one of the interesting feature which this particular product has. You can see this is the torture testing videos. And these all helps from the digital marketing perspective, these kind of videos, guys. Right, so the idea is to actually showcase your strength and point. The phone gets rotated, turned, whatever techniques are there, whatever good things which your particular brand has, that can be done. So this is being shown that it also takes much more in the water if you put across the phone, then does it really get affected or not, all these torture testing techniques. So not much in terms of you can do from the content creation, but you can give always ideas and get that promoted across. The bigger major challenging task, guys, is to find out those influencers. And these influencers can only be done with the help of researching upon YouTube, checking for people who have got good, great video channels. Excuse me. So yeah, you can see these kind of videos, guys. That's with the content part, guys, what you should have it for YouTube. Right, so I've already shown across the video unboxing videos. How do you go ahead, search for what sort of video unboxing you should have and get that done. How to tutorials, I've also shown you like how do you should, how can you cook a certain recipe, how can you install a particular router, whatever your product may be, how to drive a car, whatever sort of product you are into, how to videos, product comparisons, unboxing. That's what is really important. Now, this is one important thing, guys. In the how to tutorials, what you should focus is these major three things. The first of all, when you should start a particular video, shooting across a particular video, start with tell them what you're going to tell them. So sort of summarize the things, a sort of an index you should have. You should summarize what you're going to tell them in the entire video. Summarize in the initial portion, and then start with the second part, starts with what you are going to tell. Tell them that stuff. And when you are ending the overall stuff, when you're ending the video, just a recap. Tell them again what you have told them. So a sort of a recap. A summary in the beginning, what you're going to cover, and then the major crux of the video, which you have to cover, which you have to tell them. And the last thing is what you have already told them. So tell them what you're going to tell them. Tell them what you have to, and tell them what you have already told them. This is one of the criteria, guys, which you should focus on when you are devising on a particular content strategy for a YouTube video marketing. All right. The next thing is the how to tutorials. When you are done with creation of the videos and how to do videos, also have certain notes also being prepared across, and you can mention these notes within your description of the videos also, right? So let me showcase. You can even optimize your videos. Let's say if I take my channel and I go ahead and open a particular video. Let's say this is the playlist I have, the Sunday batch. Okay, this is from not from here, from video manager. This is going to actually happen. So my channel, I go into the my channel first, then to the video manager. And I can go ahead and optimize my specific particular video as well by putting in right title tag and description. I hope most of you are aware about that. Let's say if I have to edit this video, I can go ahead and edit that. So this particular video, if I see what is this video talking about in all, I can take that stuff, select certain keywords and get that across. Okay, so this was a major basic understanding of digital marketing video. So I can go ahead and change the information and write in, as I can select for a specific keyword. Let's say basics of digital marketing. That's my keyword which I want to type in. I can go ahead and type in that, mention a comma, and then right. So I hope it's pretty much clear in terms of how I can go ahead and even optimize my video. You know, on page optimization can be done. I can go ahead and even change across my excuse me, description. That can be done, but make sure your title and your description should not be same. So what we should do to video, to make the video, we should use the same techniques. The on page and off page backlinking also needs to be done. So Guru Prasad has a question, how can we make our videos come on the first page? Same on page and off page, a lot of backlinking is needed, Guru Prasad. I'm not really sure whether you have attended the off page optimization. There is this video for that, a recorded session, and I'm also going to take on page and off page with the Monday batch also. So there's going to be a recap of it. So on-page and off-page optimization techniques, which we do for our websites, similarly, those points, those things should be done across for videos as well. All right. So I can change that, basics of digital marketing and so I can go ahead and type in all the stuff, even the keywords being there. So once I have embedded the keywords, embedded the title tag and meta tag, that's the on-page stuff, guys, which you go ahead and do for your video. Similarly, you can do the off-page stuff, right? When I say off-page, you can create backlinks for that. So Shubham says it means we should submit our YouTube video links to bookmarking sites. Absolutely right, Shubham. You should go ahead and submit your video link to bookmarking sites to classify it to article submission sites. I mean, get backlinks for your website as sorry for your video as well. You got that right. So all those who have attended already the off-page optimization, they would definitely get to know that. And off-page optimization is a technique where you get backlinks for your website. And similarly, you can get backlinks for your videos as well. Getting backlinks for your website would always help you to get you know, your optimization, get rankings for your website. All right, guys. So that's with the content part. So product comparison, like I've already mentioned, you can do comparisons between two products, but don't do it from your official channel and do it by getting these kind of videos done by all those influencers, all those people who are video bloggers. Get in touch with these video creators. I've already shown you across one of the channels which a video blogger owns. You can go ahead and message them and they will probably charge you. You know, charge you for creating certain videos and uploading them since they already have a fan following, right? So product comparisons, how do videos, unboxing of stuff. Then you have the product reviews, the one which we have already seen, the Nike one, where people go ahead and even after unboxing, can you say the name again? Which name, Dhruv? The name of the blogger are you talking about? So then we have the video blogger. Okay, the name of the video blogger, I didn't check for that, but I can let you know where did I see that. So that it was one of the example. Right, this was the one. So Cold Freezer is the name of the YouTube channel this particular video blogger has, and this video blogger is doing really well by creating a lot of videos, right? So you can have more product reviews websites where you can go ahead and encourage your you know team members to go ahead and create certain kind of videos. You as digital marketer would good give certain recommendations what sort of videos should be there. These all videos will always help to get more traffic onto your website. If your website, if your video also ranks and your videos, these kind of videos are present on your YouTube channel, somewhere or the other, people will land onto your videos. The trust factor will get built in. The brand visibility would be there. The brand image gets created. And the overall, when the decision changes, your sales will definitely improve. You can already see how other brands are already using these kind of techniques. So you have product reviews, and then you have the torture testing where I have shown you for a mobile phone. Whether it blends, whether it works well, even if it goes inside the water, all these things, right? So that's with the torture testing, guys. And so what exactly you need to get started? You do need a YouTube channel, right? A YouTube channel can be created just with the help of a Gmail account, a Google username and a Google password, a username and a password. Go ahead and get that. And just check for whatever resources you have, whether you have a camera or you have people who can shoot videos for you, just have a check of your inventory, your resources which you have. Right. And then go ahead and create a publishing schedule. A content calendar schedule, guys, is very much important. So when I say a content calendar, it's like you decide on when should a particular video come over and on what particular date. Let me show you one of the content calendar template I have. I can even share it with you. Right, I do have one with me right now. This is something which I use for overall updates and also for posting for whatever content I have decided. I've opened this, you can see, for Facebook, for Twitter, for LinkedIn, for Google Plus, and overall monthly calendar kind of a thing. What sort of content do I want on what particular date and what particular time to be pasted across? So this is the text which I had devised already. I plan well in advance as a social media expert, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, whatever, or YouTube. That's what we decide on, that a one particular Facebook status update will go, or one particular video has to be created this way. So if you want, I can share this Excel sheet with you, which has been clubbed very specifically on the number of days of the week, the date, the time, and what message it would be gone across. Sure, I'll share that, Shadab. This is something like I use it in a practical scenario with my clients. With my clients, I generally go ahead and create a content calendar for 15 days well in advance. I send my ideas. I create certain ideas and send that across to my client saying that these are 15 updates. These are certain 15 content updates which I would want to be posted across on your website. They go ahead, check it, give their opinion. If something has to be edited, we rework on those stuff and then get the final one approved. And how do you decide about the timing? All right. That's a very great question. The timing thing is being decided on the basis of my audience, Shadab. If my audience, let's say, I have to see when does my, or I can sort of do a primary research by asking my audience, when is the time when they spend time on Facebook. If it's, the morning hours, I would always go for the morning hours. So on Monday, which is, the very first working day, do they check their majorly people check their Facebook on Monday mornings or Monday afternoon or the Monday evening? A sort of sense about your target audience would actually help you understand on the timing part. If your audience spend a lot of time on Saturday, Sundays during the night hours, then you should look at these night hours on Saturday. If on Sunday early morning, they look at Facebook generally in the morning hours, you should go for that. And Fridays, Thursdays, Wednesdays, they are generally, it's totally dependent upon what your audience. What we have seen, if we don't get an answer from our audience, a concrete answer of what timing works for them, we do a sort of a hit and trial. We do a hit and trial by posting across content on certain days at certain period of time. If we get good number of likes and comments or shares, then we get to understand that yes, or maybe views, then we get to know that for this particular day and this timing, maximum views are being reported, so one should use that. So it's always on the basis of the audience usage. If audience is using, right, then that makes a lot of sense. All right. So that's with the content calendar, guys. I'll share that with you. So we need to do the testing. Absolutely. You can do the testing, or you can even ask your audience either ways. If you get an answer, that's great. All right. So that's with the... So how to make a video viral? I mean, is there any process for that? See, the way you can make video viral is only with the help of creative content you can think of. You must have seen many people doing a lot of cheesy stuff, a lot of, different kind of things. So videos can be made viral only with the help of content. Yeah, do crazy stuff. That's what Ashish said. I mean, I have seen so many people doing stupid activities, making videos of that, and then only the videos go viral. Otherwise, even if you try to promote it as much, even you do as much backlinking and the content is not that great, it can never go viral. It can never go viral. The viral thing depends a lot on the content part. If you are a great thinker, creative guy, then the viral thing only can happen. People have made a lot of spoof of Arvind Kejriwal, of Mr. George Bush, Obama in the past. I mean, they have got their videos. So how to monetize the videos? See, how do you get a mo we're going to cover the, what do you say, Google AdSense in the next class. But let me tell you, the way you can monetize videos is with the help of Google AdSense. What you have to do, you have to get your, what do you say, once you have uploaded videos, either you have an AdSense account, you can connect your AdSense account to that, or whenever, so ad, you can go ahead and create an AdSense account, guys. AdSense account, I hope I have told most of you what AdSense is all about. This is one way, or either whenever you are submitting across your video, whenever you are submitting across your video, it's always going to ask you for the monetization part. You have to go ahead and get that approved by YouTube. So I have already done that part. You can see in the when you are uploading it in the info and settings tab. In the info and settings tab, you have the monetize with ads. You have to go ahead and get that approved. Right? This can only be done, the monetization part can only be done if your video which you are uploading is absolutely your thing only. What is the standard for video? So when you say standard as in, so there can be any sort of video, but the only thing is you don't need to copy a video from somewhere and get that posted. It has to be an original content of yours, which you only own it, right? Yes, absolutely, Dhruv, we do have. So the standard for video is like it should have a uniqueness. It should not be a copied content. So whatever videos I am posting across, even I am monetizing it. I've just started monetizing it, not much, but with my other AdSense account, I am getting great traffic and all that. Absolutely, a lot depends upon the views. A lot depends upon the views. So just a sec. I've just gone ahead and saved that part. For every video, you would be asked for the monetization part. It would actually go ahead and ask you for what sort of videos do you want to video. Minimum views are required. No, there are no minimum views, but for taking out money, there is minimum $10 which is needed, and there are no minimum views. There are certain parameters which opens up once you have 1,000 subscribers. Once you have 1,000 subscriber, you can go ahead and ask for a sort of a funding or donation. So minimum subscriber base, if you have 1,000 subscriber, first of all, you can have a custom URL. This is one thing. When I say custom URL, it means youtube.com backslash forward slash digital marketing Pathshala. At present, you can see with my particular YouTube channel, I don't have a custom URL. Reason being, my channel just have 121 subscriber, guys. If I will reach to 1,000 subscriber, I can have my own custom channel, and I can even have a page where I can ask for donations from others. I can ask for money. If people feel that yes, they are liking my videos and they want to go ahead and pay me something, they can do that. So that's the overall monetization part, guys. Whenever you upload a video, it will always ask you, for the monetization stuff. All right. So you can see my video is getting monetized. It does. When I go to the video manager link, when I go to the video manager in the video section, you can see the monetize tab coming across. Right, and it does have the overall, what do you say, how many views have I received for each and every videos. So it says 24, 8, 29, 38, this way, right? And other thing, I can check even for my analytics. When I say analytics, I can check how my overall videos are performing. So what has been the overall viewership of my videos? You can see the very first video has got a views of 70, then estimated times being watched across is 419. The amount of money which I have made is just 39 cents. So all these things are being mentioned across over here, right? I can even check for the real-time stuff, guys, how many people are checking my videos at present. Even that can be seen. So in last 48 hours, it was somewhere close to one estimated view, then three, and then one estimated view again. And for last 60 minutes, there haven't been any person who has checked my videos. If I go further down, I can check for each and every video what has been the overall stuff. The viewership report. Similarly, on the left hand side, I have the estimated earnings, the ad performance. You can see almost somewhere close to $1.55, the total estimated earnings. Since I have recently started this particular channel, that's why it's just $1.55. One of the videos which has given me maximum is 39 cents, then 36 cents, and 20 cents. Not much, guys. I mean, it can only increase if I create a lot of videos and promote them. All right. So there's a lot of stuff in the left-hand side. You can see what it gives me, a lot of information in terms of where is this video getting watched? Where are my videos getting watched? India is the country where my video is getting watched the most. Play around with your video channels, YouTube channel, guys. Analytics you can get for your videos as well. Likes and dislikes, all that stuff. The major focus was, as a digital marketer, what sort of videos you should have. Like I've already told you, you should go ahead and create a publishing schedule. I would share the social media calendar with you. All right. Okay, so that was the product reviews, torture testing, and you need to create a channel and perform an inventory test and also look for a create a publishing schedule. Right, that's with the YouTube, guys. And the next one is the Twitter. I hope each and every one of you is a part of Twitter. All right, thanks, Ashish. All right, so you guys are part of Twitter. So what exactly Twitter has got, when I say, how is Twitter different from Facebook? That's my question, all right. What things can you see which are part of, you're not part of, Shadav, you're not part of Twitter. Okay, no problem. So it's a micro blogging site, absolutely right. And why do you think there is a potential with Twitter when it comes down to digital marketing? Why should one promote stuff on Twitter? So very first question was, what is the difference? And Shubham did answer, it's a micro blogging site, which is absolutely right. Anybody else who wants to let me know, what difference can you see between Facebook or a Twitter or a YouTube? So Lena says, people follow Twitter account. Absolutely. A followership kind of a funda is there with Twitter account. This is a micro blogging site. Any idea how many characters limit are allowed when you tweet? "146," says Shubham. Tina says 125. 140 characters is the maximum character limit which one should use whenever, I mean, which one is being allowed, right? I'm just, let me show you one of the Twitter account I have. I don't use Twitter quite often, guys, but the way, the reason is because Twitter is more used by a separate kind of audience. Though it's on Facebook to follow, but not common, that common. Absolutely. Even with Facebook, you have the followership kind of a thing. With Facebook, you generally have, getting connected to your friends, sending them across your, sending them a friend request, and your friends accept them, or either you accept their friend request. But with Twitter, you don't have a friend of kind of a philosophy where people, sort of send you a friend request and they accept it. With Twitter, usually once you create your profile, you have a follower and a followership following funda. You can see this is my profile, guys, and 318 people I am following. So followers are 318 and 312 people are following me, and I've got 392 tweets. This is my profile overall in case somebody wants to even connect with me. and you always have So can we follow n number of people? Absolutely, you can follow as many people as you want. But if you would see major bigger brands, they have more people following them as compared to they following someone else. Even with celebrities, majorly celebrities or bigger brands, they always use Twitter to let everybody know what exactly are they up to. What sort of things are they doing? Are they... So anything about their life, about, you know, any updates about the brand, they all are punched across, not just on YouTube or Facebook, but also on Twitter as well. And with Twitters, you can also share across your pictures, your videos, but not the same fashion the way you do it for, what do you say, Facebook guys. You can see, I can go ahead and tweet whatever update you mention. It's a tweet and it says it's 140 characters, guys. So 140 characters with a photograph you can mention, and what all things you should take care of via as a digital marketer for Twitter marketing. Let me start with my presentation. All right. So Twitter marketing tips for smaller business owners. All right. Sorry, I skipped some of the slides. All right. So one very first thing when you are creating your profile on Twitter, you should go ahead and optimize that as well. When I said optimize, you should have a perfect logo with a keyword being mentioned across for the description, similar to what you do for other profiles also, whether you're creating a Facebook page or you are creating a... So assume I'm use Guru Prasad has a question. Assume I'm following 1,000 people. If I share any ad, are they able to see that? No. If 1,000 people are following you, then they would be able to see. So there's a funda. If people are following you and then you share something in a tweet, then only they would be able to see. You follow all those people, then you would be able to see what they are sharing. You getting me? So if I follow 1,000 people, I would get to know what these 1,000 people are up to. Whenever they share something, it will come on my profile. So same thing would be on Facebook. Absolutely. Same Facebook also. In Facebook also, same thing works. But Facebook generally, people are not that into following and followership kind of a thing. They generally go ahead and do the either like stuff. So if you like a certain page, you would get to see their updates. Or if you are a friend with someone, you would get to see their updates in your newsfeed. I hope everybody is aware of newsfeed, the homepage of the Facebook, where you get to see who's doing what, who's visiting which place, who's checking out what, and what pictures, whatever they're typing in. So if you are creating your profile for the very first time, make sure you have certain keywords which you are using for your Twitter profile. Select at least a couple of keywords, guys, for which you should optimize your Twitter brand as well, your Twitter profile as well. Try to make them part of your content for the information section which you are typing across in the Twitter profile. Pretty easy stuff, like I'm telling you. Get your website URL also up there, location, and your brand name with your logo. With the website link, you will always get a backlink to your website, guys. If you are mentioning across your website URL in your YouTube channel or your Facebook channel or whatever, you get a backlink also with the help of these things, right? And number two tip is to be consistent. So I'm not consistent with Twitter, guys, but if you are looking at I don't take major products with Twitter as well. I have certain you know, clients for which we are doing social media. I have my team who keeps promoting across stuff on Twitter. And the idea is to, you know, be consistent, keep posting across, sharing across something, let's say once in a day, twice in a day, or whatever frequency you think it works appropriate. How do you decide what should be the frequency? A lot gets decided with the help of the competition which is there. If your competitors are doing really well and they're doing it three times in a day, you have to really match up to them. You can't stay behind. At least get to the mark to which your competitors are doing really well. If you want to be in the leading phase, then do something extra to what your competitors are doing, right? Next thing, guys, another tip is to keep interacting with all those people who are whom you think are going to be sort of make sense for you, for your business. So, you know, there is a funda of sending direct messages, like the way we send direct messages on Facebook. You can send direct messages on Twitter as well. Let me showcase that again. So the messages tab on the top, you can see. Okay, there's certain problem right now with Twitter. There is a messages tab. You can send across messages and get that connected. So pretty easy stuff. I mean, not much of a rocket science, which I'm telling you. Right. Yeah. So be consistent, be keep interactivity stuff, and use keyword hashtag. So Santosh, will you show how to tweet? Absolutely. I'll show how to tweet. So same thing would be on Facebook. What same thing would be on the Facebook? The messaging part would be definitely there on Facebook. The followership will also be there on Facebook, right? And so the other point which I was telling you, use keywords which you are targeting in your hashtags. Let's say I go onto my Twitter profile, and within my Twitter profile, I mention, I use a hashtag for my keyword. So I use a hashtag which is shift and three button, and I write Google Panda 4.2. Okay, Google Panda, I'm telling you what exactly a hashtag is. So hashtag is something which you should use always before your keyword, guys. So if I have a keyword, Google Panda, for which I'm trying to rank my website up, I would mention Google Panda rolled out recently. Did you guys got major changes in your, I'm just writing in something, search engine rankings. Nick Bartla, I type in my name and I can go ahead and mention across my URL as well of my website. What I'm doing, I'm giving a backlink. Okay, so I'm giving a backlink to my website. Okay, the character limit has for if in case. So hashtag, guys, I hope my keyword was Nick Bartla, my keyword was Google Panda. I want these keywords to be, you can see even the trending hashtags are over here. If somebody has created this particular hashtag, let's say Shatrughan Sinha, okay, I click on this trending hashtag, open it in a new tab, you would see all those tweets which carries this hashtag Shatrughan Sinha one. All right, so you can see people are, all those people who have used Shatrughan Sinha as a hashtag, their tweets get represented here. So Shatrughan Sinha is being used here. Shatrughan Sinha is being used by another person. This is a way to actually popularize something. You know, using a hashtag is an in thing, you know, you can say, or sort of a fashion which has become these days to popularize something. You can even say 24 years of Rishi Prasad. I'm not really sure what exactly is this one. One rank, one pension. Five words to make awkward black coffee. And these are all major why at the rate is used. See, at the rate is used whenever you have to just post across a message, you know, tell it to a certain individual. If I do at the rate and somebody who's following me, let's say this person, Toronto SEO, is following me. If I do this, I pension, you know, at the rate SEO Mississauga. So I mention at the rate and mention anybody's profile. Okay. I mention anybody's profile, then only they would get to know that their name has been mentioned in the tweet. But with the hashtag, a particular generic term, which is a keyword, that is being promoted across. And if so many people will start using this, it can become a trending topic. You can see for Red FM, a hashtag, a trending topic has been created. If I click on the Red FM hashtag, all those tweets which other people have used in their tweets would get represented over here. You can see the Red FM one, which NDTV has shared, that gets over here. Similarly, you have Red FM for by this person, Venugopal, then from Dazzling Diva, then from Abbas, whatever, News by Crowd, whatnot. I mean, whosoever is using hashtag Red FM, you can see Red FM, either Red FM in their text of the tweet or also as a hashtag. You can see Economic Times have got Red FM within their text also and within their hashtag also. This is a way to popularize something, guys, and also be part of a sort of a revolution also, which people have started using. You can read more about hashtags and read by just Googling around. But that's the overall, in layman language, if you have to popularize something and you have a keyword from an SEO point of view, use your keyword, place a hashtag before your keyword. So these are two keywords of mine within my tweet, and I am let's say I'm asking a question to a particular person. Okay. If I go ahead and post across a tweet, that's what I've done. I have asked a question to SEO Mississauga also, and I have used my hashtags, the ones which I wanted to, right? So that's with the hashtags, guys. And like I said, use the hashtags within your keywords. That's one thing. Just a sec, guys. Right. And so once you have used these, the engagement parts becomes much more easier. People will find you very easily if you're using the hashtags. If I'm using the Google Panda one, the keyword which I used in my hashtag, people will find me easily whosoever is also talking about Google Panda update, right? This is one of the algorithm update, guys, which is called Google Panda, which has recently come, because of which the overall search engine rankings do change since they refine the Google search engine refines their algorithm. Tip four is to actually include website link in the tweets. So this is another thing. If you can really submit across your tweet along with a particular URL, let's say my website URL was nickpatla.in. And since I have a restriction in terms of the character limits, I can always go ahead and use a particular resource, guys, which is called Bitly, which shortens up URL. This particular tool, bit.ly, will always help you to shorten your URL character limit. If my website URL, which I want to share across, let's say it's pretty long, it's nickbartler.in/contact, blah, blah, this and that, I can go ahead and change that part. Most of the people have also, I have used Bitly for also my this particular GoToMeeting invite also. You can see with the GoToMeeting link was this long, https://globalgotomeeting.com/join/50969737. I got a smaller, you know, Bitly link for this, bit.ly/nick-digital-marketing. It gives me, so the URL also got smaller, and also some sort of analytics have been being given to me. Today on 26th of July, it shows that 12 people have already clicked on it. And on last Sunday, which was 19th of July, 15 people have clicked on it. So it does give me certain stats also, and I can I'm giving you the same example. I can go ahead and shorten up my URL, the Nick Bartla contact one, by mentioning it over here. So Shubham says, is there any difference between Bitly and Google? No, there is no difference. They both are sort of competitors to each other. I can go ahead and edit that. Bitly. So that's the URL, guys, which I have created. And I can copy that across if I open that. So why would not we use Shubham? Ask me a question. Why would not we use a Google link shortener? You can use that as well, Shubham. And there is no difference between these. I hope I did answer this. If you open this URL, guys, if you open this same URL, which I have shown you, bit.ly/nick.contact, nick-contact. If you open this, the same URL will open up. It will automatically get redirected. The reason why I have used this is because this has given, you know, condensed the overall URL. Let's say if I have a way too big URL, all right? For an example, let's say I go into the YouTube channel of mine. I take the URL, which is this particular one. Can you see what a long URL this is? I can go ahead and even shorten up this URL. And I can change it. Sorry, I can customize it. So let's say DMP videos. Now I can share this across with each one of you. And if you'll open this, you'll get all the videos, guys. bit.ly/DMP videos. Right, that's the overall objective of Bitly, guys. It really shortens up the entire URL and helps you with the overall character limits. You're not going to face the problem which you generally face by submitting across a long URL. So let's say if I take this one. I go into the Twitter channel, guys, and within the Twitter channel, if I am typing in something, right? Check out my videos. If I type in the same big URL, it would take a lot of space. I can just go ahead and type in this bit.ly/DMP videos, right? So 96 characters are still left. If I go ahead and type in the same bigger URL, you can see how many characters would be left in that scenario. I mean, you will have more space with the help of Bitly. You will have more space to type across. Okay, it's somehow not taking more space, but it should. There's some problem. Just a sec. I hope most of you are clear on why Bitly is being used. I don't know why it's not taking. When I'll post, then only it will take. So I don't want to post it right now. 140 characters is the maximum which you can really go ahead and check. Okay, 140 characters, guys. All right, so how long is this Bitly URL remains? It remains forever. I've got certain Bitly URLs which are there for the past 7 years also. So there is no limit to it, and it's a free tool, which is the best part, that it remains for longer period of time. Right, guys, so include the website link and have the hashtag and also the @ button. The @ is used whenever you have to connect and specify to someone that, yes, this question is for you guys. I'm mentioning you. If you want to mention someone's profile within the tweet, then you go ahead and use the @ button. Guru Prasad says, Twitter is publishing ads like Facebook. If yes, how can we clear the ad? Okay, surely. So Twitter does have ads, but only for the US and the Canadian market at present, not for the Indian. Yes, ads are shown on Twitter. I'll surely take that in next session. Thanks for, getting this point across. And I'll surely take that in next couple of sessions. Right, so beware of auto direct messages. Auto direct messages are there. Okay, sorry, these are no more there. Auto direct, so they were direct messages, but auto direct message have got decreased now. They are no more there. So forget that part. You can ask for the what is the difference between at the rate and hash. Okay, I think you joined in a bit late, Saurabh. I did take that in detail. At the rate is when you actually try to specify to a certain person that yes, I am asking a question to you. Okay, I did take an example of a tweet where I used both the things at the rate and hashtag also. With hashtag, you are using a particular term as a keyword, and that keyword can get popularized and that can become a trending topic also. It's a generic topic for which you to use a specific hashtag, and for at the rate is for the person. Absolutely, Guru Prasad had answered that. So at the rate is for mentioning it to a specific person, and hash is for keyword. Right. So have a look at the recorded session of this with this entire session. You'll get more details. Right. And the other thing. So ask for a retweet, right? Absolutely. You can ask. So this particular thing, guys, is called a retweet. If somebody shares your tweet, is that is called a retweet only. So like the way we have a functionality on Facebook where some if I post in something on my profile and another person clicks on share button, then becomes a sort of a retweet only. Retweet and Facebook share, they both mean the same. My post, my tweet, which I have submitted across, which I have tweeted, if you guys are following me and retweet that, what will happen? It will become part of your tweets also. Your tweets will also come in within your tweets. My tweet will show would be shown across, and you can your followers, people who are following you, would also get to see that tweet. That's what generally happens with the retweets, guys. Are you? Is this getting clear to you? Let's say if I retweet this part. All right. So let's say I tweet this one, and I mention that. I mentioned that I am retweeting your tweet. What will happen? It's not letting me to. Strange. It's okay. So what has happened if I have done the retweet part? Now this particular tweet, which was already getting showcased to her followers, now would be showcased to my followers also. Reply and retweet are different. Absolutely, reply and retweets are different. Can we do paid marketing? Yes, absolutely. In India, you cannot do. In India, the Twitter paid marketing is not what do you say enabled at present, but with US and Canada, it has got enabled sort of. And we're going to take the paid version. I'll surely try if I can get hold of any website for which I can start doing the retweet part. Oh, sorry, the paid part. All right, so that's with the retweet part, guys. It's some very much similar to like share part. If I have retweeted someone else's tweet, not only their followers who can see it, now even my followers would be able to see it. It's something like very similar to like getting things popular. If people would start retweeting a certain tweet, it will sort of become a viral thing. All right. So that's with retweet. You can go ahead and message across people and tell them to retweet your stuff so that that can po get popularized. You can sort of request them. And it's a generic thing, guys. I mean, it's being said that if you would not tweet longer, if your tweets would be even lesser than 100 characters, it will have a much higher engagement. Lesser the characters in your tweets, much better it is. I mean, it's one of the observation which has been seen so far. And there is another thing, guys. You can use photos within the tweets. There are platforms like pics.twitter.com where you can go and use them. Otherwise else, you can, when you are posting across something, you can post pictures within your tweets from here as well, from directly from Twitter as well. You can go to pics.twitter.com, and from there also you can do that. So when you're posting across a tweet, you can mention, you can add a photo from here as well, right? So that's what the photograph, and there are certain ways through which you can have smaller videos also being part of it, and you can schedule tweets. So for videos, there is a particular application called Vine application, which you can use on your phones, guys. So Vine is one way through which you can create. So you can see it's actually available for phones only, for the Apple phone, the Android phone, the Windows phone. You can download these as an app and create a shorter video. A shorter video can be created with the help of Vine. This is one of the most popular application, guys, through which you can get videos. You can see one of the videos like this one being, you can see how small it is, the overall video. So it was somewhere close to 3 or 4 seconds. People create certain videos and share that across on YouTube. The idea is to actually showcase it to all those people who are following you. Dubmash are also, right? Dubmash is definitely an app for sure, right? Where people are sort of taking that, recordings of famous celebrities, majorly Bollywood players, and using that across, and they share that across with the help of Facebook and Twitter also, right? Yeah. Viva Video, okay. Viva Video app is also there. I'm not really sure on that, but I was sure on the Dubmash and the Vine app, right? I can check for that. Shut up. Thanks for sharing that. So that's with the videos, guys. And there is another tool which I was telling you. You can schedule tweets with the help of this particular tool called Hootsuite. Hootsuite helps you how to add the videos. Okay, for adding the videos, Santosh, we would definitely need a mobile phone. I wish I could have a way through which I could have told you, since this can only be done with the help of a mobile phone, Santosh. Vine apps are only available for mobile phones. What you can do, you can download these apps and download these apps on your whether it's a Android phone or Apple iOS. With the downloading of this video, this app, Vine app, it will let you create a video for 3 seconds or 5 seconds, whatever. And just once you're done with this, it will automatically tell you, share it or tweet it. I mean, share it on Twitter or tweet it, whatever you do it. So and once you do that, it becomes part of your tweet. So pretty easy stuff. Just go ahead and do that on your phone. This is actually a laptop through which I'm teaching. That's why I don't have the access to the mobile phone. Shadab says it's not working much as an app. Hootsuite. The Hootsuite is not working. Is that what you said? You tried it. Can't we add video through laptop? No, you cannot. Videos cannot be added through laptop. That's the even with Instagram, with Instagram also, you cannot add pictures. You cannot add yes, for Twitter you cannot. You just need a mobile phone to actually get that done. Like I was telling you, so Shadab says Hootsuite doesn't work, but my team is actually working. Yes, Santosh, we cannot do it for Twitter. The videos part cannot be done for Twitter through laptop. Vine is the most popular one. I can still search and see if there is any new application which is helping us to post across videos with the help of laptop. There can be, but that would probably be a new one. I might have to research on it. So I can research and then get to let you know about that. But what I would do, so we can do the same stuff, how to upload videos on Twitter from computer. You can see so many people are typing. Okay, so there are certain ways through which people are doing it. How to upload any video to Vine. So, okay, this one, maybe you can go through these some of the videos and then check for it. I would also go ahead and educate myself on that, because the way I get that done is only with the help of mobile phone, right? So how to upload any video to Vine, that's something which you can check. All right, so I'll give you more information on that once I check for that. And then the other tool which I was telling you through which you can sort of schedule content for future. When I say for future, how can you schedule content? You have, let's say, created content for next 15 days in that same Excel sheet which I have shared with you. You can sit one day and get that schedule for overall next 15 days. Just sign up across on Hootsuite and get your profiles, configured across. So up to three social media accounts can be configured for free, right? So you have social profiles up to three, and you can even go for the paid versions by connecting 50 to 100 social media profiles. So I don't have a profile right now. I used to work earlier on with this. I can go ahead and create an account. Maybe I can create an account and show it to you in the session we'll have next class, guys, and then show you across. It's pretty easy to get your social media accounts connected and then schedule it across. So I've just logged in with the help of All right, so I've just logged into Hootsuite, guys. Just have a look. I have connected some of, okay, it was way too early or way too in the past that I have connected. You can see my Foursquare account, my Facebook account, my LinkedIn profile. They all are connected over here, and my Twitter account. So if I go to my Twitter account, it does shows me across my tweets. You can see this was the latest tweet which I had done in front of you, the Google Panda one, and I also retweeted one of the tweets which someone else had, right? I can go ahead and schedule that. Just a sec, guys. So if I go to the publisher part, they have changed their overall stuff in way too much. So scheduled. All right, so guys, I might have to spend some time onto this because there's a lot of change. Which okay, yeah. So they have come up over here. Let's say if I type in. So whatever I type in, I can go ahead and schedule that stuff. What I have done, I have posted across one tweet. I can do a scheduling part. I can mention that I want it across to be submitted on 31st at 4 p.m. and email me whenever it's being sent, and I can press on the schedule button. Or I have to select the social network. So that's my Twitter. That's my Facebook profile, that's my Facebook page, and that's my LinkedIn profile, guys. I go ahead and do the schedule button, press the schedule button. What will happen on the same date and same time which I've scheduled it, the tweet will automatically go, the Facebook status update will automatically go, the status update on LinkedIn will automatically go. I have initially got my social profiles configured to it, guys. So that is something which was not being shown to you since it was being done way back. What you can do, you can start adding stream, add social networks over here. So you can add your social networks. You can connect with Twitter, Facebook, Google Plus. You can connect all that stuff from here, guys. Right, so I've connected. I'm connecting my Google Plus page also. Okay, it's actually if I go beyond 33, sorry, three social media profiles, it's going to charge me. So I'm not doing that. So that's the free version. With the free version, I can just have three social media networks, which I already have: the Facebook, LinkedIn, and the Twitter. So Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, I have got that in place. And once I've got that in place, I can go ahead and schedule things the way I want it. Right. So that's with the scheduling. I hope it's pretty much clear. It just needs some certain practice, guys, through which you can actually get that done. And give me a second, guys, just a second. Sorry, there was a phone call. That's why I had to actually go on the mute mode, guys. All right. So you can monitor your brand mentions. When I say brand mentions, it means that if somebody is typing across for your brand, you can do a hashtag and check for your brand mention. Let's say if I go into the Twitter account and I do a search Twitter, I press across hashtag. And let's say I do Honda. All right. So I can check if I am Honda, I can check what people are really talking or posting about my brand. So that's something which should be done on day-to-day basis for your brand. Hashtag Honda. All right. So that's with checking the brand mention, guys, and also scheduling across content. Twitter chats is something which is not more there. Earlier they were. So a Twitter chat, other what do you say, sections, certain apps are there, but not it's not that popular. So I'm skipping that part. Twitter chats was part of Twitter earlier on, but not now. Right. So that's with the Twitter guys. It's the same thing. So that's with YouTube and Twitter. And the other thing which I want to talk about is Pinterest with social media marketing. Where to check it? All right. So it's the search box. So what I have done, Santosh, on the top of the Twitter profile, can you see hashtag and then Honda? That's what I have done. I went to the home page and I mentioned the brand absolutely. Hash. Tag and let's say if I do Maggie, all right. When I do Maggie mention, you can see all those mentions in the whatever tweets, whatever people are typing in the tweets with Maggie being mentioned across, my brand name mentions related tweets come across right in front of me, right? Right, so you can't hear me. Why is that? Shut up, can you? Guys hear me? What happened? Sorry, you didn't get me. Okay. Can you hear? You can hear me. All right. So what I have done for checking brand mention, let's say I'm from Maggie, what I would do hashtag on the top on the right hand side of the Twitter account. When I go to twitter.com, all right, on the twitter.com, can you see the search bar? Within the search bar, you type across hashtag shift ha 3 and then you type across your brand name. And then what you get all those tweets which various people would have done. Okay, I think All right, so everybody, I think everybody else is able to hear me. Shada was not able to hear me. So, like I said, when you press across hashtag with the brand name, you know, you mention across your brand name, what you get across all those tweets which people have typed across with your brand name being mentioned in their tweets. You're just doing a social media listening part, Santosh or everybody. With this thing, with typing across hashtag and your brand name, you're doing a social media listening where you get to know about what people are talking about your brand. What people are talking about your brand, you go ahead and do this, you know, brand mention thing. Check for your brand. Are people talking good stuff about your brand, bad stuff about your brand? You get all these tweets. So somebody is saying, is the colonial answer to Maggie ban? Somebody says, someone is making Maggie in my building. Yes, I can smell it. I want Maggie, right? So somebody is writing that kind of stuff. So Nestle says, Nestle India to get new MD post, Maggie row, whatever. All right. So that's the kind of thing, guys, which you should do for checking out the brand mention. I hope you are clear on the Hootsuite part. I'm sharing across the Hootsuite URL once again. So do practice across with the Hootsuite and also try and use the retweet stuff and all the other stuff which I'm talking about. All right. So with respect to Twitter, and now I'm just, what is TweetDeck? Okay, TweetDeck and these peer index. These are majorly, you know, what do you say, certain applications which are related to Twitter only. I have used TweetDeck but not peer index. I'll just open and show it. So in case if I want to know what people are talking about on real time basis, then I can go ahead and enter my Twitter username and my, there are plenty of applications which are there with Twitter, with Facebook and whatnot. If I mention across one specific person whom I want to sort of track, right, then I can go ahead and do that with the help of Twitter, TweetDeck, sorry. So these are my activities, my messages, my notifications I get to know from here, and I can create certain rules where I can just mention that I want to read a lot of stuff about this particular person. Activity. Okay, TweetDeck also helps you the scheduling of tweet. So I don't see major difference with this particular application. Again, this is an application. Peer index, I'm not really sure. TweetDeck I have used in the past, but what I can see doesn't give you much. I've just explored it, that it doesn't give you much other. Okay, over here you can create certain list. You would have to give me some time, Nathan, to actually check the peer index and TweetDeck's major functionalities, and I can get back to you. So I would write that down. There was another thing which I had to get back to you, which was with the how can we put across videos with the help of a laptop, right? So I'm noting down a couple of things which I have to check and get back to you. All right, so TweetDeck. And the other thing is how to upload videos on Twitter with a laptop. Right, so I'll have to educate myself for this, and then I can get back to you guys. Right, so TweetDeck and peer index. Just recall me in case I forget, guys. So mark me across an email and I'll help you with that. So TweetDeck and peer index. All right, thanks for giving me that chance to actually learn and then get back to you. Thanks, Nitin. And thanks, Santosh. I'll get back to you on that. And the next thing, guys, is Pinterest. Just wanted to check with you. Are you guys there on Pinterest? Have you guys seen Pinterest and sort of created your profile with Pinterest? Yes, says Guru Prasad. All right, no, says Saurabh. No, says okay. So, guys, Pinterest is okay. How about Flickr? So, Flickr is not much used these days, but Pinterest is a very important social media tool which is used by digital marketers these days. It's a platform. Pinterest is a platform where, again, a social media platform only, where you can go ahead and create your profile to collect images. Squido is something different. I've not really checked. I use Snapchat for sure, but Squido is not really sure. I can go ahead and still check that. So I've not used. Okay. Okay. Squido, the spelling may be different. Squido is now Hubpages. Okay. So Hubpages are actually something like article posting. So Squido and Hubpages, guys, if you have been part of the off-page optimization tutorial where I have gone ahead and told you about how to get backlinks with the help of article submission sites, Squido and Hubpages are similar kind of websites where you can go ahead and sign up and post across content and get backlinks. So these websites like Squido, Hubpages, article submission sites, they all help you to get backlinks to your website. So Squido is like that, Guru Prasad. Even from Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, you get backlinks. But also along with that, you get your social media marketing being done across. So I was coming onto the, Pinterest part. So with Pinterest is a social media tool where you can create your profile and create certain albums. You know, create just, I mean, whatever images you come across in the entire internet world, you can go ahead and save them across. And save them across in a well-specific, categorized fashion. And Pinterest helps you do that. Many people have Pinterest profiles. Many brands have their Pinterest profiles. Let's say if I talk about Starbucks, you can see many bigger brands have created their presence on Pinterest and reaping benefit out of that. You can see their recipes, their drinks, all of that has been categorized specifically. They have created certain albums. Now, albums, just like the way we have albums for Facebook, guys, similarly, albums represent boards. An album on a Facebook or a board on a Pinterest means the same thing. A single picture on a Facebook account or a Facebook album or a pin on a Pinterest means the same thing. A pin is very similar to a single picture and a board is very similar to an album. There are two things in a Pinterest, guys, a board and a pin. Board means the album and pin means a single picture. You can see I have already logged in over here. This is my profile. I don't have major boards and pins. You can see 12 boards and 18 pins. All right. So if I go ahead and let's say I have got this board, Nick Bartla Services, I can sort of add more pins to it. This is one pin which I've already uploaded. I can go ahead and add more pins to it and either I can import them from a website or I can sort of choose and get them uploaded across from wherever. I mean, whenever I do that, let's say I'll go ahead and upload a pin and showcase it to you. So let's say I go ahead and upload a particular image as a pin. It will ask me for similar kind of things, which when we do uploading of a video also, which would be the description, the backlink, you know, even the link would be asked for. So I've got this pin. I have to select for which board I have to mention it. So I go ahead and let them know that I want to make it part of this particular board or the album, whatever you want to call it. The idea behind using all these services, all these websites are, guys, because as digital marketers, you're always looking for brand visibility, for leads, for sales. And if your brand has a visibility and presence on all these websites in a right fashion, the overall marketing for your brand will happen, you know, in a most effective fashion. So these are certain ways through which you do it. Now, this web image which I have uploaded, or the pin which I have uploaded, has got uploaded into this particular board. I can go ahead and edit that and mention whatever description. So whatever description I want to mention, in case I want to give a backlink to my main website, I can go ahead and do that as well. And I can mention for what place. So if it does give me an option, let's say I do this and press the cross save button. So I have got a backlink, right, for my website from here. Similarly, I can create multiple boards and multiple pins. I have shown you the ways, what do you say, Starbucks have done, and I can even show you what, like, the way some of the e-commerce website might have done it. So if I open Flipkart, you can see all the categories they have on their website, whether it's bags, mobiles, women's section, the product section. Let's say if I go into the fashion part, you will see all the products which are in the fashion are presented over here. So how the follow and follow, absolutely, there is a follow and follower stuff over here as well, and they work in the same fashion. If I want to follow a lot of people, I can do that, but whosoever follows me would only get to know about the updates on whatever new pictures I have uploaded. If I have uploaded a new picture, only those people who are following me will get to know that. And these are certain boards, guys, like I've already shown you, and these are the pins. So, I mean, overall, you can see the pins right up here. And if I want to check the boards, I go ahead and click on boards. It says different boards are all together mentioned over here. You have the Flipkart.me, the kids part. You have fashion, different, the current offers and whatnot. Right? So these are the ones, guys, which you generally go ahead and only those people will get to see you who would follow you. That's the sad thing. Right. So yeah, that is actually. So you can create different, you know, boards, and underneath boards, you should create different profile pins. The idea is to get backlinks also and have presence on these websites, guys. So I'm going ahead with certain other things which I have to showcase with Pinterest marketing. All these are mentioned over here, guys. All the, I hope you know that whatever presentations I'm using, they all are visible to you. They all are available to you on a particular URL. Once I'll end the session, I'll share the links again with you so that you get the access for all the videos and all the presentations. Okay, I go further down with Pinterest. These are the things, certain presentation slides. So 25 ultimate Pinterest marketing tips and tricks for small businesses. So what Pinterest is, I have already shared with you. It's a picture and also video sharing site, guys, absolutely. So you can share across videos on Pinterest. So not just the picture I've shown shared, I can even share a video on a Pinterest, but majorly it's used for picture sharing only, guys. All right. So Pinterest is growing very rapidly. It's one of the most popular, you know, tool which businesses are using these days for getting promoting across their stuff on the internet. So Pinterest drive greater traffic to websites combined with Google Plus, YouTube, LinkedIn, and other websites. All right. So you can register as on Pinterest, create a username with your business also. Even a business can also go ahead and register. Just try doing that. I've already done that. Same stuff which I've already mentioned, like you should have a keyword-rich information tab. A keyword-rich information tab like you should have on a YouTube account or a Facebook account. Similarly, for a Pinterest account, you should have a description with keyword-rich text. Add your website, which I've also spoken in the Twitter thing. So when you have the Twitter account, when you are creating that, you should mention your website, even with a YouTube account. Similarly, with a Pinterest account, you should mention across your website URL. So after creating a Pinterest account, you should start creating, you should think of certain themes, and these themes should be used for creation of the boards. And underneath boards, you should have various pins, which are the pictures. It's very important to think on these themes, or what do you say, the boards categories, which you want to place them. And when you will pin across these pictures on the boards, they'll all get shared to all those people who will follow you. There is a funda of follower and following also with Pinterest. I can go ahead and follow each one of you on Pinterest. And whenever I follow each one of you, whenever you upload something on your Pinterest account, I can get to see that. But you won't get to see my stuff until unless you don't follow me, right? So all those who follow you will only get to see your stuff, right? So you can even connect your Pinterest account with your social media sites like Facebook and Twitter. So whatever thing I have uploaded just now, the picture I have uploaded, guys, I have got my even Facebook account connected to it. You probably might get to see that the image which I shared on Pinterest automatically goes onto my Facebook profile. Okay, somehow it hasn't come. I would have to see, the connectivity might not have been there. But you can go ahead and connect that, connect your Pinterest profile. You can go ahead and connect your Pinterest profile with your Twitter and Facebook too, so that whenever you submit across something, they also get mentioned on your Facebook and Pinterest profile. Sorry, Facebook and Twitter profile. Okay. So it says share on Facebook, so that can be done, right? Right, so I can share that across and whichever way, but there is a way to actually get that automatically done also without me interfering into it. So integration part can be done, and the integration, there's a particular URL for that. I'll give you that. So integrate. So it was actually integrated earlier on, and I don't know why. So there are certain, okay. Yes, this link to Facebook, that probably in my settings tab, I would have to go and check for that. So in my settings. All right, so account settings, if I go to, I have to see, I can go and mention that I have not mentioned across my website and all that. So that should be done by, all right, so you can see the connected part being done over here. I don't know why it didn't happen. Whatever I posted, maybe it will come after a time, certain period of time. I can get, if I go into the settings tab, I can connect my Twitter profile, I can even connect my Pinterest profile with other applications, my Twitter or my Facebook or whatever. So my Pinterest is connected to my Facebook, to my Twitter, and I can even connect my Google Plus. All right, so that's the one, guys. That's the thing. You can go ahead and do that. So it might take time. Absolutely right. It is going to take time. Definitely this particular thing which I've uploaded just now, it'll get appeared on my Facebook profile in certain period of time. Right, so that's with the integration, and you can also let people know about your Pinterest profile by having a specific button, you know, which you can mention on your Facebook, sorry, on your website. Like you have a follow me button of Twitter or Facebook on your website. Similarly, you can have a follow me on Pinterest button on your website. Just it's one of the thing which you should do in order to encourage people to look at your Pinterest profile as well. As a digital marketer, I mean, this is something which should be done. And you have other buttons also which you can submit across on your website where people can go ahead and click and follow you across on Pinterest, same stuff. And it is one of the important activity if you are trying to create a good presence on Pinterest. Create as many quality images, get your designer in place and get good quality images and videos being created and get them posted across on Pinterest website. And also you can have your username, the way you have a username for Twitter and Facebook, you can also create a username for Pinterest, guys. The way you can do that, I have it for, so if once you will create your account, then only it will ask you for a username, guys. So it gets done automatically by going either to the settings tab or when you are creating the account. Likes, commenting, pinning across different pictures will also create a lot of interactivity between you and other people. So that's something which should be done. Not just pin your unique stuff, but also repin other stuff. So there is a funda of repin also. So let's say if there was a retweet where you are not just tweeting your stuff, but you are retweeting other stuff. If I want to retweet anyone else's picture, that's something also which can be done easily. So let's say I want to repin. If I get to see a certain image, which I want to go ahead and retweet, which one should I do? Okay, let's say if I do want to go ahead and pin it across, I can go ahead and pin this, and this is sort of a repin. An image which Flipkart does have, I can pin it across in my particular boards also. If I want to check, you know, I'm collecting pictures which I like, which others have uploaded. If others would also do that, I can make it secret also and get that. But as a digital marketer, if you have a brand, you should go ahead and encourage others to repin. You can create other profiles by yourself and do that. What is the use behind this? The use is that if others are retweeting or repinning, then the popularity is happening, right? That's the only funda. It's becoming viral. If I am repinning certain stuff, then my people who are following me would get to see that. Similar to like Facebook sharing or like retweets, absolutely. So Flipkart has shared something and I share it on my profile, on my boards. So people who are following me would get to see the same stuff. You getting me? Like the retweet stuff, people who are following me would get to see that Flipkart stuff again. So encourage people, if you have good quality image, automatically people will repin it in their own boards. These things, guys, whether it's Twitter or Pinterest, they are majorly, you know, used in the US market. Very few people have started using it in the Indian market. It's only the celebrities or bigger brands who are actually using it. So repin is another thing along with pin. And then you can pin interesting stuff, informative videos and all that. Of YouTube also, that would make a lot of sense. And always write informative description. This goes without saying. So even if you're repinning certain stuff from other people's pin, then you can go ahead and write in a good informative description so that people get excited, enticed to actually go ahead and click on them. And if you want to publish an image on your website or blog post, you can embed option. So there is an embed option also. Let's say there are certain pictures which you have shared across on your Pinterest profile. You can share the same thing on your website by embedding. So there is an embed option in the settings tab or let's say I go onto my board. Okay, it's for sending image. I go ahead and click. Right, so here is the embed code, guys. Here is the embed code. So you can see embed board. What I did, I went to the board part and I clicked on the settings tab and send, oh, sorry, not send board, make a widget and copy the code. And if you know how to play around with the code, you can go ahead and submit that across onto your website. It will get automatically shared across in the same way. It will appear in the same way it's appearing on the Pinterest tab, guys. That's how you go ahead and embed that. You can see even my slide share, this is an embed thing which has happened. This particular, what do you say, presentation, I've already uploaded on slide share. You can see the slide share icon, but I've embedded onto my website. So Sharap says, I just want to know if you will be able to take a session on how to create interactive presentation or slides like one you use frequently. I don't take it, but if you're creating a request, I will take it. So if it's a request. So guys, if, whenever you feel that there is certain topic, like somebody also did mention about TweetDeck or about how do you create, submit across videos using Twitter, on Twitter using this. So whenever you have a request, let me know, let me know, guys. I would go ahead and embed that. Incorporate that within my overall course curriculum, right? So I have got a request. I would take that for sure. So point taken, Shalab. I'll do that. So I would rather share across a suggestion, a feedback tab right now. Within your feedback, guys, you can mention across whatever things which you want me to really take care of. I would share the feedback link in a while. So that's with the embed code. And then you can also use the iPhone app where you can click pictures and get that uploaded right away on your Pinterest account. So you have an iPhone app. And how and where to embed the code. All right. So embedding the code happens on the website, Santosh. So like the way I've got this presentation, I would take a session on WordPress also. You know, how do you go ahead and work around on WordPress? So within the WordPress based website, you can go ahead and embed the code. Let me share with you how I can do that. Let's see if I open my website. I open the backend of my website. I have got your website created, Santosh and Guru. I would share that, share the details with you on Monday, which is tomorrow. So the name server and all that stuff. I believe for others, I have already shared. So Nitin, you have your website. Dhruv, you have your website. Lena, your website have also been shared with you. Shubham, I would create your website in case you want that. Ashish, if also you want the website, I would do that for you. And Shadab, I would also do that. So I have Sharif also. You can let me know in case you need a website. All right, so please share somebody's website. So right, somebody's website. Okay, I can share that. So this is one of my student who has, done changes to her website. So I can share that, Shadab. All right, so moving on to the back end of my WordPress-based website, I can go ahead and embed that in whatever way I want to. I would take a different detailed session altogether for WordPress on how do you get that thing, get these things done. So I have taken already with the on-page optimization. How do you go ahead and make changes onto your website with respect to on-page? Let's say if I go onto one of the posts or let's say the lessons part. One of the web page which I am opening within a WordPress based website, let's say this is the one, right? So Shubham has shared across his website. Thank you so Shubham so much. So within the one of the web page of a WordPress, how you can embed a particular code is, let's say I go onto the Pinterest page again, click on the embed code, get make a widget, click on the make a widget, get the embed board. All right, take the overall code. I have copied the entire code, guys. I'm going back to my website and I'm going ahead and clicking on the content part, pressing in this across. Let's see whether this is gonna help me to get it. Alright, so now I would view how does it look like, whether the board has got embedded or not. Like I said, I've already got what's this? Why this is being lost? Just a second. Okay, I would see which particular tool works for this, because okay. There is actually an embed code tool which is needed, guys, for Pinterest thing, and I would get that uploaded and then show it to you. So within the WordPress, so we have one complete session for WordPress, please, so that it will be easier for us to play. Absolutely. I'll surely take this session as a separate one. Sure, where I would show you how do you go ahead and create, embed the topics and all that stuff, and also the blog post and all the other stuff. Right, guys, so that's with the Pinterest. Just a second, guys. So it's appearing in a while. So Pinterest, that's all major things which you can do with Pinterest marketing. And I hope nobody is going to sleep. Nobody is going to sleep. I'm not making you guys sleep. So that's with the Pinterest stuff, guys. Excuse me. Okay, thanks, Guru Prasad. Also, you can also create certain images which are sort of, you can watermark your images and then submit across. This is another tip and trick. So after the iPhone app and embedding across, other tips and trick is to actually watermark your images. I hope you understand what exactly watermark means. You can ask your designer, so you would get access to your designer to actually create certain images and watermark with your logo, so that nobody goes ahead and use the same images which you have created. So this is another tip. Another trick is to create certain boards which are seasonal. So let's say Rakhi, Raksha Bandhan is coming, or Independence Day. You can create certain stuff like around those, and as a marketer, you can create content for that. You know, you can create boards for seasonal sessions. You have certain offers going on. You can create pictures for that and circulate that across, not just on Pinterest, but at all the places, whether it's YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, whatnot, LinkedIn, all that. Right? So That's with the iPhone app, the watermark, the seasonal stuff, and choosing the keywords in the description. That's something which I've already told you. Use the cues, the specific keywords. And right. And if you want to see who's pinning your images and videos, you can find it on this URL, which is pinterest.com/source/ your site. Let me open that and show you. It was Pinterest. It's not working. Otherwise, there is a way through which you can actually check who all are pinning. So let's say if there is somebody else who has pinned across your stuff, then you can check it. Pinterest.com/ your site. Strange. I'm not really sure why this is not working. I would check and let you know, guys, why is this not working. Probably this has changed and something else is there for that. All right. I don't want to make you go to sleep. And other thing is, guys, you can also, with respect to e-commerce website, this is one of the other best technique to whatever product images you are taking in the Pinterest pins. Also mention the price to it, whether it's through with the help of dollar sign, rupee sign, pound sign, whatever. It's always makes a lot of sense to mention across the price within the image only. So whenever that is getting created, the image is getting created, try to make as much use of that image, get maximum mileage. If yours is a e-commerce site, get the price being part of it, right? So that's another. You can also create special board for your company's team members, the about us page or the press release page, the media page. So these are certain other tips and tricks, guys. And also you can have another board where you can have the new stuff about your particular company or your organization so that your followers trust you more. Your news board is a different board. Your special company's team members board is a different board altogether. So it's a sort of a website which you're creating on Pinterest with the help of images only. And when you're getting repaints, comments, likes, analysis, then I mean, you can always see, analyze that it's always helping you to get traffic and engagement on your website. And also, if you are hosting certain webinars, let's say even I am also taking this training part, but the idea is that one should actually make good use of these tools, create a small video or a picture and get that uploaded across on Pinterest and all the other social media platforms. So rather I should start doing it myself and then showcase it to you, right? So use Pinterest for case studies also. So in case you have certain portfolio to be shown across your whatever stuff you have delivered so far within your brand, that can be shown as case studies that you have delivered this to that particular person, this to that particular person. And certain contest stuff, if you are running a particular contest, make them part of your Pinterest pins, guys, just for more popularity. And last but not the least, you have a lot of other Pinterest tools and goodies which you can go ahead and play around with. So you have a Chrome extension, you have a WordPress plugin which you can go ahead and sort of play around with it. So that's with the Pinterest, guys. You can get all these lessons. I'm sharing the link with you. I am also sharing the link for the before you I let each one of you go. Please let me know the feedback, whatever things you want me to target. Let me know how was the session all about, and any comments and any suggestions, let me know in the in this particular feedback form, guys. Once you're done with the feedback, let me know, and then we'll wrap up the session for today. I hope everybody is okay, already doing that. Okay. Samir, thanks a lot, Nitin. I have thanks a lot, Shubham. I've shared the URL for the videos also, where you would find all the recorded videos. And also, I'm sharing the URL where you would find all the lessons being part of it. Thanks a lot, Guru Prasad. Really appreciate that. Thanks a lot, Santosh. Really appreciate that. So, I'm sharing across the URL for having getting the access for the videos, which I've already done. And there was another one. Sure. Guru Prasad, definitely we can talk about it. And thank you so much, Shadab. Really appreciate that. I'm just trying to write. So. Thanks a lot, Ashish. So this is one of the link for the lessons, and the other link is there for the videos which I've already shared with you. So the DMP lessons and the DMP videos, both the links I've shared with you. You can get access to all of them. And thanks everybody for your wonderful support for taking out time. So thanks, Ashish. Thank you, Dhruv. Thanks, Guru Prasad. Thank you, Nitin. Thank you, Santosh. Thanks a lot, Saurabh. Thanks, Shadab. And thanks, Sharif. And thanks, Shubham. So I hope each and everybody have shared their feedback. In case not, then please do help me with that. And we'll connect. So tomorrow, 8:30 to 10:30 also, we are having a session, and which is going to be about Google Display Ads and remarketing majorly. We have covered the keyword match types. We have also covered the ad extensions, but we'll do the implementation part of it tomorrow. Somehow it shows it's not available. Sorry, what is not available? Dhruv, let me know which URL is not working for you. Okay, it was not for us. Yeah, the unreachable, which one is not reachable, Dhruv? The feedback form, the feedback form should open perfectly. Try opening that now. I hope everybody did the feedback. That's why I'm assuming that it's working for everybody. No problem, guys. Thank you so much for your time. I think it's 13 minutes over. I have taken more time of yours. Thanks to everybody for thanks a lot, Saurabh, for appreciating. Thank you, Ashish. Enjoy your rest of your Sunday, and we'll connect tomorrow. In case you are joining in, 8:30 tomorrow in the evening, we will be connecting. All right, guys. See you then. Take care. Bye now.